occasion, on the field of sports, at your workplace, just open the bottle and savor the pure, refreshing taste. Holy Natural Spring Water is produced in Mama Can St. Andrews and is available in all sizes nationwide. To order, telephone 444-7654 or 533-7654. Holy Natural Spring Water, Grenada's purest bottled water.
Mark your calendars, football fanatics. The GFA is turning 100 this year, and we're ready to celebrate. It's GFA's Legends Weekend, a three-day extravaganza kicking off on Friday, May 3rd, and running all the way till Sunday, May 5th. Witness history in the making. The Caribbean taking on the world in a clash of legendary international footballers on Sunday, May 5th at the electrifying Kirani James Athletic Stadium. Get ready to roar with the crowd as iconic legends like Emmanuel Adebayo, El Hadj Diouf, Alex Song, Michael Essien, Luis El Matador Hernandez, Shaka Hislop, Asamoah Gyan, Ricardo B.B. Gardner, Russell Latapy, Shallery Joseph, Jason Roberts, Dexter Dapps, and a whole host of superstars light up the pitch. From breathtaking goals to unforgettable memories, GFA's Legends Weekend promises an epic celebration of football you won't want to miss. Keep your eyes peeled on GFA's social media for the full squad reveal. GFA's Legends Weekend. Be there.
Kite flying contributes significantly to power outages on our system. In fact, from January 2017 to March 2019, we had 143 kite flying incidents on our system affecting over 31,000 customers. This approximates to about two-thirds of our customer base. We also have power surges, and these are spikes in electrical current which can negatively impact electronics and other appliances in the home and businesses as well. When kites entangle our lines and the lines clashes, you have sparks which can fall to the ground and cause bushfires as well.
Greenlink operates a network that where voltages range from 230 volts all the way up to 33,000 volts. At that level, basically any sort of contact with the lines can result in electrocution, especially when you're not contacting the lines with proper safety equipment. A kite is simply pieces of fabric that can be moist depending on the conditions outside, and so at the higher voltages, the risk of electrocution is definitely possible.
It's a major strain on the company's resource to restore power after a distribution cut caused by kite flying. We have to send the crews out there to first of all investigate, then to restore power. We recognize that kite flying is a very important tradition to the Grenadian public. However, we would like them to do it safely by staying away from power lines, to avoid personal injuries and disruption to the service to our customers.
This Easter, be safe, be considerate, fly your kites in wide open spaces away from power lines.
Grenlec, energizing our community.
Are you looking for a reliable, affordable, and customer-friendly pharmacy? Look no further than Hills and Valley Pharmacy, the nation's leading healthcare products and services provider. We are committed to serving you at convenient locations. Find an extensive and affordable selection of prescription and over-the-counter drugs and medical supplies at Church Street, Hillsborough, Karaku, Jubilee Street, Grenville, St. Andrew, near the bus terminal, and Halifax and Grenville Street, St. George. Our committed team is always available to offer valuable assistance for managing your health and wellness. Discover the additional benefits of our wholesale distribution on Halifax Street and our Medcare Center on Grenville Street, where we provide in-house physiotherapy, massage therapy, doctor consultations, and eye care services. Our commitment is to satisfy all your healthcare needs, including competitive prices, loyalty rewards, and special discounts for seniors. Contact us at 435-6904 and WhatsApp 535-4734. Choose Hills and Valley Pharmacy. Remember, your health is our business.
Hello and welcome to the MTV Evening News for Tuesday, April 16th, 2024. The news headlines come to you in association with Courts Grenada Limited.
Keeping up with the kids' growth spurts might mean it's time for a bigger fridge. Don't worry, at Courts, we got you. Or maybe you're ready to turn your home entertainment up a notch? That means a larger TV and soundbar? We got you. Excited about making your new home feel more like you? We've got you. Need a better mattress for more restful sleep? We've got the size and comfort that's right for you. So shop today and pay later. Whatever you need, we've got you. Courts, bringing value home.
Coming up in the news tonight, Guelph gas station workers to be compensated. Government confirms plans to appoint a new high commissioner to Ottawa. Guelph fisherfolk cry victimization. And in sports, four Grenadian players selected for the Windward's under 19 team. The details when we come back.
The first segment of the MTV Evening News comes to your compliment, Nexa Credit Union. With you, wherever your road leads.
When you need someone to help you to your feet, I'll be that beacon to your highest peak. Ooh, I'll be right next to you, no, I will never leave. Come on, take my hands, we got everything we need. Cause you can look to me,
yes, I can.
Whenever you're in need,
yes, you can.
Just call on me and I'll be on my way. I'll be by your side,
by your side.
Never to divide,
never
the light that shines always. Wherever your road leads, we'll be right there with you. Wherever your road leads, we'll make your dreams come true.
Nexa Credit Union, with you, wherever your road leads.
Good evening. With the news in detail, I am Troy Gill. With 3 months having elapsed since the Guelph gas station workers were laid off, a union official revealed that payments are being issued to the former employees without the union's knowledge, potentially violating the collective bargaining agreement between the union and the company.
President of the Bank and General Workers Union, Joseph Mitchell, has shed light on the ongoing saga surrounding the fate of 6 former employees of the Guelph gas station, which ceased operations in January. Mitchell disclosed that the company and former owner, Sylvester Qualis, have commenced payments to the workers without the knowledge of the union. The closure of the gas station prompted the union to raise concerns over the sudden termination of the 6 full-time employees without the provision of terminal benefits. Despite efforts to negotiate with the company, Mitchell informed our news team on Tuesday that they were at a deadlock, necessitating intervention by the Labour Commissioner, following which they discovered that the company agreed to initiate payments without informing the union.
Since then, we have learned from the workers, some of them that is, that the company have started to pay them sums of money. We are not happy with that. We are happy by virtue of the fact that the workers are getting money, but certainly because the union is involved now, what ought to have happened is that the company should have worked through the union, because we would first have to verify that what the company is paying is consistent in keeping with the collective agreement. Also, the Employment Act talks about, notice in lieu, and so in that case, notice in lieu would come into play. Their outstanding vacations that the workers claim that they're owed, and all these sort of monies that's outstanding.
Mitchell expressed the union's displeasure and revealed that they immediately sought clarification from the company. In response, the company assured them of a briefing on the proceedings thus far and their commitment to compensate the workers in line with the collective bargaining agreement.
So we were given bits and pieces of information from some of the workers. And ultimately what we did was to engage the employer, expressing our concern of what is happening. What was shared to us seemed to have been the decision was taken out of ignorance, not understanding the process. And subsequently, we have been promised by the employer sometime this week that they would furnish us with a complete listing of what has been done and what they intend to do. So, I mean, ultimately, we are hopeful that we could put this matter to rest. At the end of the day, what is important is the workers getting their compensation for the years of service.
In a new development, the Commercial Transport Enterprise Cooperative Service Center, CTEC, recently announced its acquisition of the operations at Guav and potential vacancies. However, Mitchell noted that several of the former employees have expressed disinterest.
We understand that a new entity has taken over the Guav gas station. We have heard that, by the way. Our arrangement with the Guav gas station would have come to an end because the collective agreement is between Guav gas station and the union. Notwithstanding, we hope that those who prefer to seek continued employment will be given some form of opportunity. Some of them said to me that they were not interested in that line of work anymore. But hopefully we are hoping that those who are interested could be given that sort of opportunity.
According to Joseph, over $50,000 is owed to the 6 former gas station employees in Guav, St. John. For MTV News, I am Lichelle Murray.
Chairman of the National Democratic Congress and former government minister, Sylvester Qualis, will serve as Grenada's High Commissioner to Canada. He will be based in Ottawa. Foreign Affairs Minister Joseph Andel confirmed plans for Qualis' appointment during a press conference on Tuesday.
Yes, government has moved to, or we are in the process of moving to open a high commission in Ottawa, Canada. We recognize that to gain maximum benefit from our diplomatic representation in that country, that it is more productive, more sensible to have a presence in the capital where the decisions are made, where you're more likely to have an impact. Once we get the green light from the Canadian authorities, we'll be proceeding full steam ahead with the physical setting up of that mission. And of course, we will continue to maintain our consulate in Toronto, where the majority of Grenadians in Canada reside.
Qualis served as Environment and Social Development Minister under the 2008 to 2013 NDC administration. Grenada's Education Minister has disclosed significant areas of collaboration established through a Memorandum of Understanding between the Republic of Cuba and Grenada in education, which also includes a heavy focus on the development of programs tailored for the holistic development of students with special needs. More in this report.
Following a visit by Prime Minister Honorable Deacon Mitchell and a delegation of ministers and government officials to Cuba to mark the 45th anniversary of Cuba-Grenada relations, Education Minister David Andrew highlighted several areas of continued cooperation in education during a special press briefing held on Tuesday. According to a government release, the Prime Minister and his team were set to sign 9 memoranda of understandings, including upgraded agreements in health and education. Andrew revealed that a visit to the Maurice Bishop School for Special Education prompted an agreement that will lead to the development of special education programs and bolstering the development that caters to students with special needs.
They have put a lot of emphasis on special needs and early intervention, early diagnosis between 0 and 6, and the earlier the intervention, the greater the chances of being able to remedy the situation. And so there's area for cooperation there. And at our ministry, we are very deliberate about offering a wider suite of services to our special needs population. So we've strengthened the department. We have a new head of special needs. We have a few more officers who have been appointed to that department, so that this comes at a very timely moment when we can offer more services in collaboration with the technical expertise from Cuba.
Additionally, another agreement has been forged that will continue to facilitate the teaching of Spanish in primary schools, aiming to broaden the linguistic skills of students.
Then we have the teaching of Spanish and English as foreign languages, and this falls well with us also, because you would be aware, we have started introducing Spanish in primary schools. So last year we did a certain number. We think this year we've introduced it to a further 10 schools. So there'll be over 20 schools, just over 20 schools now, doing Spanish as a second language at the primary level. But of course, sustainability is always an issue. So cooperation with Cuba in an area like that will certainly benefit us well. And that was one of the areas that we have in the Memorandum of Understanding.
Andrew further added that an agreement has been established to reintroduce the Yes I Can adult literacy program, which forms part of the Cuban literacy campaign.
Then another area was the literacy of young people and adults through the implementation of the Yes I Can program. And that's a proven literacy program that works with adults. If my memory serves well, I think it was once used in Grenada, probably during the revolution. And it's been used in other parts of the world to raise the level of literacy in adult populations. And so the Yes I Can program is one of those areas for cooperation, and we are actively pursuing that, even at the ministry, setting up the infrastructure to begin to get the technical advice and guidance from some of the experts we cooperate there to see that come to fruition.
Cuba has also extended 22 scholarships in medicine and health for the upcoming academic year, which commences in September 2024. MTV News, Donessa Pantru.
What was supposed to be the start of the preliminary inquiry into the murder of Victor Randy McIntosh of Kariku is tainted by accusations of manipulation and a miscarriage of justice. As we hear in the Kayla Flavany report, the inquiry scheduled to begin on Tuesday has been pushed back by almost 2 months.
The start of the preliminary inquiry for 49-year-old businessman Dwayne McDonald was to begin on Tuesday morning at the Magistrates Court in Kariuku. However, attorney-at-law Anselm Clowden is accusing the prosecution of manipulating the proceeding by intentionally denying physical access to McDonald in the court by having a virtual proceeding. He spoke with MTV News via telephone from the Sister Isle.
Make sure that McDonald is in Kariuku. I need to speak with him. I am not required to go to the prison to see my client. My client has to be brought to court, especially during the conduct of the proceedings, so that I can meet with him, I can assess the demeanor of witnesses called by the prosecution. This is a preliminary inquiry. And therefore, from time to time, in the conduct of a criminal trial, you must be able to access your client. How would I access him on virtual?
Only one of the over 10 witnesses showed up to court on Tuesday, and Clowden says no explanation was given to the magistrate. He maintains that the accused should have the opportunity to be physically present during court proceedings.
A slate of 10 witnesses, you only had one in appearance, and no proper excuse for the absence of those witnesses was advanced by the court, by the prosecution, save and except. Prosecutor raises, after I admonish him as defense attorney, and the magistrate rebuked that conduct and said that the accused must be present so that when evidence is being led, he can consult with his client to give him guidance and direction for cross-examination.
McDonald is expected to appear in court on June 19, 2024 in Kariuku, when the preliminary inquiry will begin. In the coming weeks, Clowden intends to file an application in the High Court to bar virtual hearings in the matter involving murder accused Dwayne McDonald.
I am going to take an application before the High Court to stay these proceedings until full disclosure is made. They have made an amendment today to add additional witnesses. And it was only today they served me witness statements. Justice must not only be done, it must be seen to be done.
After spending more than a year on the run in connection with the May 2023 death of Victor Randy McIntosh of Carriacou, McDonald was apprehended in Trinidad on January 23, 2024, and deported into the custody of the Royal Grenada Police Force on Saturday, January 27th. For MTV News, Kayla Flavany.
Fisherfolk in Guelph, St. John say they are fed up and frustrated with the Guelph Fisherfolk Corporation and claim that they are being singled out for voicing their concerns on MTV a few weeks ago. More in this report.
The Guelph Fisherfolk say they are being victimized after speaking out to MTV News last month, seeking clarity on the Guelph Fishermen Cooperative financial report that has not been revealed to them for more than 2 years. MTV News was at the Guelph Fish Market on Tuesday and spoke with several fishermen who indicated that since the news item was aired, they are being victimized by members of the Fisherfolk Cooperative.
I command the news, we speak about the problem we have with the gas. And then since after we speak, I speak on the news about the gas, I come in with me fish and to ask questions. Every time I come, we ask the person receiving the fish, just now. You have to talk to the boss, and the men just stop taking me fish just because I come on the news and talk about the gas. And the, when I speak about the gas, I didn't have a waste conversation over the news. I get result because when I watch the gas bill after, the gas bill moved from one price to the other. When gas price go up on the news international, I see gas go down in the pump, so that make me see definitely had something between what wasn't plain right for fishermen.
Desmond Guild, fisherman for many years and former vice president of the cooperatives, is distraught over the situation and is hoping for a speedy resolution.
I stand firm and I kick against it. But what I notice is the minute time you start opposing certain things that he is doing wrong, immediately a letter is sent for you, your membership is terminated. But according to our constitution, nobody else besides the members cannot throw out a member. But because of he manipulates and he dictates and he have everything under his umbrella, he does what he wants, he throw out people, and then the fishermen is so hesitant and so cold and so thing, they don't know how to. And sometimes I get frustrated.
Cecil Joseph is another concerned fisherman.
Well, the fishermen have to do something else with it. Yeah. You understand? If they don't think they have to find some way to sell it or whatsoever. But I just don't understand why the victimization. Because if as you speak here, they will do that to you. And other people, other fishermen want to speak in. But they're afraid. Because if they come here and see them anywhere on the TV anyway, the next time they're telling that guy that don't take the fish. Don't take it. And they are members of the cooperative. They are investors. They are shareholders. And we just cannot get the board to make that decision to get to a four-man board we have right now. You understand? And a cooperative cannot run a four-man. What we ask them to do is to either resign, I call a meeting, a general meeting. Let members select who they want to lead them.
The fishermen met with Prime Minister Honorable Deacon Mitchell a few weeks ago. However, they are again calling for a general meeting to discuss challenges faced by the board and wants the Prime Minister to intervene. MTV News reached out to member of the St. John's Fisherfolk Cooperative, Alvin Ferguson. However, he chose not to comment until he meets with other members of the board. For MTV News, Kayla Flavany.
That's the first segment of news. More news when we come back.
The first segment of the MTV Evening News came to you in association with Nexa Credit Union, with you wherever your road leads.
But when you need someone to help you to your feet, I'll be that beacon to your highest peak. Oh, I'll be right next to you.
Nexa Credit Union, with you, wherever your road leads.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on LaCour Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repair center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call LaCour Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. LaCour Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
What does it take to be an amazing woman? Lots of me time. Amazing women are classy, fancy, and a little sassy. It's the drink for me. Cheers! Sometimes you've got to show them who's boss. Alpha male? Nah, alpha females are more amazing. Cheers to securing the bag. We make time for ourselves, for work, friends, and we certainly make time for passion. We're simply amazing. Amazing cream liqueur for the amazing woman in you.
The story of Grenada is the story of Coop Bank. A story of humble beginnings, steady progress, persistence, and people, Grenadian people, making things possible. This 50th year of independence is special, and we want to help you make it memorable. Bank on a bright future with Coop Bank, as we celebrate more than 50 years of partnership with Grenadians. Take advantage of 100% financing to buy land, purchase, or build your home, or make those home upgrades. No loan fees, no legal fees, and low interest rates. Drive into 50 and beyond with 100% financing on new vehicles and get 50% off loan fees. Celebrate you. Celebrate Grenada. Make this year one to truly remember with special financing from Coop Bank. We're the Bank of Grenada and the bank for Grenadians. Visit our website for more information and apply for financing today.
Welcome home.
Grendek Community Partnership Initiative.
The theme for the science fair is water and energy strategies, the key to sustainable development. It encourages students, it promotes caring for the environment, sustainable development, and we want the students to display practical activities and real life situations of what is really going on out in their environment. And we look forward to companies like Grenlec continuing to see the relevance and significance of something like a national science fair.
Grenlec, energizing our community.
Sunshine Promotions is rolling out the red carpet for all mothers. It's a night of love. Saturday, May 11th at the dazzling Radisson Crown Ballroom. The celebration kicks off at 8 p.m. with the show starting at 9 p.m. Promising a night filled with joy, music, and appreciation. Prepare to be swept off your feet with performances from the legendary Mikey Spice.
I'm born again.
Mikey Spice. The dynamic Lion Paw, the sensational Valine, and the soulful Laura Lisa. It's a lineup that promises an unforgettable night. Get your limited early bird tickets for just $100 EC and ensure you're part of this grand salute to mothers. Tickets available at Giddens Pharmacy in St. George's, Wall Street, Wharf and Grenville, Chucky's Bar, Cass Unisex Boutique, Quick Stop, Pierce Barbershop in Victoria, Calico Shopping Center in Satez, Rena Mills in Carrickoo, Crown Collection, Plus Pharmacy Grenville, Heather's Boutique, and GoToFed.com. Stay connected with Sunshine Promotions on Facebook and Instagram for all details. It's a night of love, Saturday, May 11th at the Radisson Crown Ballroom.
What
What if you had a choice? A choice of joining a line or a choice of making your purchases online? What would you choose? While you ponder on that, the National Lotteries Authority has provided another purchasing option. All their games are now available online. Yes, Grenadians! From wherever you are, purchase your favorite daily and jackpot-type games using any electronic device. Register on the NLA's website at www.nla.gd. Top up your account and enjoy online lottery gaming at your convenience. We're taking shopping comfort up, up, up several notches. But the choice is yours. Join a line or buy online. NLA, make your dreams come true.
Ladies and gentlemen, the event of all events is here! On Sunday, May 5th, from 5 p.m., Megaforce Promotion presents
The Massive
Cars and Cash Mega Bingo at Victoria Park, Grenville. You can win not one, not two, but three mint condition Suzuki Ignis. Yes, we're giving away three cars plus $35,000 in cash. Whoa, this sounds amazing! Three cars plus $35,000 in cash? That ain't missing me! Tickets are $60 for one or $100 for two. Don't forget, free buses will be provided. Megaforce Cars and Cash Mega Bingo! This will definitely be the event of 2024. Brought to you by Carib, Glen Elk, Springwater, Specialized Auto, and Waggy T Rental.
The second segment of MTV News is brought to you in association with Arisa Credit Union. Your financial freedom, your future.
Take charge of your financial journey by switching to an Own Your Own Loan at Arisa Credit Union. Arisa's Own Your Own Loan is as unique as you are because we know one size fits all does not fit you. With Own Your Own Loan, you get unmatched benefits including lower interest rates, flexible repayment options, discounted loan and legal fees, and savings from hardware suppliers. Tailor-made options that put you in control. Switch now and step into the life you were always meant to live with Arisa's Own Your Own Loan. Arisa Credit Union. Your financial freedom. Your future. Call us today at 440-1759 or visit our website at arisacu.com.
Welcome back. The recommencement of work on the Willis Main Road may soon be a reality as government officials continue efforts to iron out kinks in construction work that began almost 4 years ago. Kayla Flavany has more.
On Tuesday, Member of Parliament for St. George Northeast, Honorable Ron Redhead, walked through the village of Willis, accompanied by Acting Prime Minister and Minister for Mobilization, Implementation and Transformation, Honorable Andy Williams. Contractors and residents. Tuesday's visit follows a recent town hall meeting with residents who engaged in meaningful dialogue, sharing their displeasure over the halting of work on the roads. The meeting was led by Prime Minister Honorable Deacon Mitchell, and according to Redhead, all effort is being made for a speedy resolution.
We are doing this walkthrough primarily to be able to finalize all of the outstanding matters with the residents and the contractor to be able to push this project forward. Again, this is something that we are not satisfied with in terms of how it was done, but at this juncture, it is about bringing everybody together, all elements, including the contractor himself and team, to be able to identify these bottlenecks and to solve this problem once and for all.
In a recent report, residents in Willis complained to MTV News about several challenges due to unfinished construction and improper drainage.
Because children falling down and the drain when they come out of school, the older people cannot come out, the lady you seen about the ladies are old people too, and we have a real problem. And every time, you understand, people walk, they can't even get their money. And they, you understand, and the cousin, corruption against each other, they were chopping, they fighting. You understand? They can't feed their family. You understand what I'm saying? So we have a serious problem.
MP Redhead is confident that following Tuesday's exercise, all the bottlenecks will be identified, ensuring that all parties can reach a finalized agreement for the recommencement of work.
With this effort, a finalization by way of a plan now would be in place, and we would be able to have specifications that are appropriate and are of standard to be able to complete this project.
A walk through the area reveals incomplete construction with exposed steel and open trenches, and property owners find it difficult to access their homes as gaps leading to their driveways remain broken. Redhead says he received reports of multiple incidents. However, all afflicted persons received the needed medical care.
There were multiple incidents where people who had work, lost work, were being frustrated as a result of not being paid. And we are working to ensure that this is something that is going to be of the past and people can start getting their monies on this project.
Work on the Willis Main Road was contracted to Hanover Construction Company by the previous government almost 4 years ago. Since the start of the project, there has been several setbacks due to terms of the contract and payment dispute with workers. For MTV News, Kayla Flavany.
Officials from the Ministry of Agriculture and Lands, Forestry and Marine Resources are now better informed on land degradation neutrality following a training facilitated by the Food and Agriculture Organization, or the FAO. Details in this report.
The 3-day workshop was geared towards addressing issues pertinent to land degradation and safeguarding against further ill use. Project manager for PISLM Soil Care Project, Trevor Thompson, stated that the training would be the foundation for establishing Caribbean soil care information systems across the diaspora.
As many of you know, we don't have up-to-date soil information. Right, for any of the countries. The last soil survey was over 60 years for Grenada. So we're not just going to take samples, do the results and put it in a hard copy book and send it to the countries. We're actually going to have a virtual, a GIS system where you could go online and see the soil's information, access it, make use of it when you advise in farmers, etc.
Permanent Secretary within the Ministry of Agriculture, Isaac Bagwan, gave a detailed layout of how the data will be used. He disclosed that the ministry is wrapping up the agricultural census, an exercise that allows them to gather in-depth information on the farming community.
And it's important to know what is the situation with our land. Yeah, we know that there is an absence of a national physical development plan, as some of them commonly call zoning, but we do have certain lands that we are aware of, and the whole idea is to track what is happening to this land, what is the soil type, and what are the crops that is best grown on this particular soil type.
Dr. Maria Cruz, lead technical consultant on the Soil Care Project, underlined the importance of the project and the various benefits that can be derived.
This is something that is of crucial importance, so it's consequential to then having a better and more sound land planning.
FAO's local correspondent, Lawrence St. Louis, expressed that it is critical that the participants make themselves fully aware of the benefits from the project and encourage them to make adequate use of the knowledge acquired.
Focus on what's happening here, because this is an opportunity for us to learn something that we really don't have a lot of information on.
The sessions were held from Monday 8th to Wednesday 10th April. For MTV News, Kayla Flavany.
Grenada's inaugural observance of International Good Deeds Day on the weekend saw volunteers going above and beyond over the weekend, fulfilling their mandate to assist those in need. Our news team caught up with volunteers in the ongoing rehabilitation of the Labory Daycare Center on Saturday. Nicole Kane from ISG Cares in Florida says Good Deeds Day is celebrated in over 100 countries worldwide and is growing every year.
Good Deeds Day is April 14th. That's the designated day. And it really means it's nothing fancy. Cook a meal for a neighbor. Check on a you know, an older person that may not have a lot of family. Buy somebody a meal. Let somebody get in line in front of you at the grocery store. It's the simple things in life that matter. I work on the charity side, so my job is to give back to the community in which we do business. So that's why I'm here.
Good Deeds Day unites people from around the world to do good for the benefit of others and the planet. Since 2007, millions of people from thousands of businesses, nonprofits, schools, families, and individual good doers have participated. The International Support Group, a facility maintenance company, made its inaugural visit to Grenada on April 14th, and during their volunteers in Carriacou and Petit Martinique and on mainland Grenada, they partnered with IGA Real Value and Arts and Soul Bookshop in providing products and books to the children of the Belle home.
Sharon Roberts came by and she saw the need that, you know, the place needed some sprucing up and, you know, make it friendlier for the kids to come every day. So ISG Grenada, you know, we do facility management and mold remediation, anything facility management related. So I work on the charity side, so my job is to give back to the community in which we do business. So that's why I'm here.
That's the second segment of news. More news after the break.
The second segment of MTV News was brought to you in association with Arisa Credit Union. Your financial freedom, your future.
Take charge of your financial journey by switching to an Own Your Own Loan at Arisa Credit Union. Arisa's Own Your Own Loan is as unique as you are because we know one size fits all does not fit you. With Own Your Own Loan, you get unmatched benefits including lower interest rates, flexible repayment options, discounted loan and legal fees, and savings from hardware suppliers. Tailor-made options that put you in control. Switch now and step into the life you were always meant to live with Arisa's Own Your Own Loan. Arisa Credit Union, your financial freedom, your future. Call us today at 440-1759 or visit our website at arisacu.com.
Over the years and presently, customers have been winning exciting prizes while ensuring that benefits are realized for all Grenadians by supporting the games of the National Lotteries Authority.
I am Patrick Simmons, former Minister for Sports and National Athletes. The NLA has made significant investment in nation-building activities. Among them are the construction of health, sporting, cultural, educational, and community facilities. Additionally, they continue to provide funding to non-governmental organizations and individuals throughout the Tri-Island State. I support the NLA's mandate because I can see where the money goes.
Playing the games of the NLA guarantees support for sports, culture, and nation building throughout the Tri-Island State of Grenada.
What does it take to be an amazing woman? Lots of me time. Amazing women are classy, fancy, and a little sassy. It's the drink for me. Cheers. Sometimes you've got to show them who's boss. Alpha male? Nah, alpha females are more amazing. Cheers to securing the bag. We make time for ourselves, for work, friends, and we certainly make time for passion. We're simply amazing. Amazing cream liqueur for the amazing woman in you.
The story of Grenada is the story of Quab Bank. A story of humble beginning, steady progress, persistence, and people, Grenadian people, making things possible. This 50th year of independence is special, and we want to help you make it memorable. Bank on a bright future with Quab Bank, as we celebrate more than 50 years of partnership with Grenadians. Take advantage of 100% financing to buy land, purchase, or build your home, or make those home upgrades. No loan fees, no legal fees, and low interest rates.
Drive into 50 and beyond with 100% financing on new vehicles and get 50% off loan fees. Celebrate you. Celebrate Grenada. Make this year one to truly remember with special financing from Co-op Bank. We're the Bank of Grenada and the bank for Grenadians. Visit our website for more information and apply for financing today.
Welcome home.
Are you looking for a reliable, affordable, and customer-friendly pharmacy? Look no further than Hills and Valley Pharmacy, the nation's leading healthcare products and services provider. We are committed to serving you at convenient locations. Find an extensive and affordable selection of prescription and over-the-counter drugs and medical supplies at Church Street, Hillsborough, Karaku, Jubilee Street, Grenville, St. Andrew, near the bus terminal, and Halifax and Grenville Street, St. George. Our committed team is always available to offer valuable assistance for managing your health and wellness. Discover the additional benefits of our wholesale distribution on Halifax Street and our Medcare Center on Grenville Street, where we provide in-house physiotherapy, massage therapy, doctor consultations, and eye care services. Our commitment is to satisfy all your healthcare needs, including competitive prices, loyalty rewards, and special discounts for seniors. Contact us at 435-6904 and WhatsApp 535-4734. Choose Hills and Valley Pharmacy. Remember, your health is our business.
Ladies and gentlemen, the event of all events is here! On Sunday, May 5th, from 5 p.m., Megaforce Promotion presents
the massive
Cars and Cash Mega Bingo at Victoria Park, Grenville. You can win not one, not two, but three mint condition Suzuki Ignis. Yes, we're giving away three cars plus $35,000 in cash. Whoa, this sounds amazing!
Three cars plus $35,000 in cash? That ain't missing me!
Tickets are $60 for one or $100 for two. Don't forget, free buses will be provided. Megaforce Cars and Cash Mega Bingo! This will definitely be the event of 2024. Brought to you by Carib, Glen Elm, Springwater, Specialized Auto, and Waggy T Rental.
Angie, don't you know that you should not fly a kite near electrical poles and wires? You should only fly it in open areas. If the kite gets stuck, it can cause power outages throughout the village.
Then I'll just pull it on, Johnny. Simple.
No. You shouldn't do that. You can get shock. You should call Grenlake at 237 and they will come and help.
Alright.
Grenlake, energizing our Grenada.
We now join Donessa Panchu for this evening's regional roundup.
This is the regional roundup for today. I am Donessa Panchu. We begin this evening's regional roundup in Jamaica. A policeman was shot dead in a reported robbery incident in St. Anne's Bay, St. Anne, on Monday night. Constable Ricardo Fairclough on the St. Anne OST was reportedly responding to a shooting incident during a robbery when he lost his life in the process. Reports are that a woman was also shot and injured during the incident. Other details of the incident are sketchy at this point. In a preliminary notice, the Jamaica Police Federation described the development as a very sad moment for the Jamaica Constabulary Force family. We are numb with pain at our colleague's demise. We pray to the Almighty to give us strength during this very dark hour. A formal message will follow. Sleep in peace, dear brother, and may light perpetual shine on you, the Federation concluded. Now in St. Martin, one man is dead while three other people are nursing gunshot wounds following a shooting near a popular nightclub in St. Martin on Sunday. In a social media post yesterday, the police force of St. Martin said that it received reports of multiple people being shot near the nightclub in Sampson Bay around 4 a.m. When officers arrived, they found a young man lifeless on the opposite side of the club. Bystanders told police that two other men and a woman also sustained gunshot wounds during the incident. Officers searched the area and found one victim behind the supermarket located next to the nightclub. He was taken to the St. Martin Medical Center in a serious but stable condition for treatment. The man was then transferred to a medical center on the French side of the island for further treatment. The other two victims had already been transported to the hospital on the French side before the arrival of the police and detectives. KPSM said it will be doubling down on efforts to rid the streets of illegal firearms. And finally, in the regional roundup in Guyana, the police have swiftly charged a mother and her son in connection with the murder of a cab driver, which occurred 3 days ago. This prompt action underscores the seriousness with which the authorities treat the case as they move quickly to bring those responsible to justice. More in this HGP TV report.
Following the killing of 36-year-old Amaziah Hohenkirk of Lot 3, Perry Street, Tugville, a mother and her son were on Monday charged with murder. 22-year-old Malachi Kennedy and his mother, 42-year-old Alicia Edmondson, both of Lot 3, Perry Street, Tugville, were not required to enter a plea when they appeared before Magistrate Sunil Scarce at the Georgetown Magistrates Court. The police case against the mother and son is that on Friday last, Hohenkirk was involved in an argument with the mother and son, which resulted in a fist fight. The police say that during that fight, Alicia Edmondson picked up a knife while Kennedy armed himself with a cutlass. They both then allegedly chopped and stabbed Hohenkirk. The cab driver was rushed to the Georgetown Public Hospital, where he was pronounced dead on arrival. Soon after Hohenkirk's killing, his mother-in-law appealed for swift justice.
Why we can't get justice? Hey, we can't get justice. Oh, me daughter get two children. She first child for the day before. Then she make another try to get married. Hello. No, I was again married with the mother. Come on. That's my dad.
Oh. The court was told that the police are in possession of video evidence. Edmondson and Kennedy were remanded to prison, and the matter will be called again on May 7, 2024. Travis Chase, HGP Nightly News.
And that's it for this evening's regional roundup. I am Donessa Pantrew.
This is the MTV Evening News. More news when we come back.
What if you had a choice? A choice of joining a line or a choice of making your purchases online? What would you choose? While you ponder on that, the National Lotteries Authority has provided another purchasing option. All their games are now available online. Yes, Grenadians! From wherever you are, purchase your favorite daily and jackpot-type games using any electronic device. Register on the NLA's website at www.nla.gd. Top up your account and enjoy online lottery gaming at your convenience. We're taking shopping comfort up, up, up several notches. But the choice is yours. Join a line or buy online. NLA, make your dreams come true.
Whatever you've been putting off, do it today with a loan of up to $20,000 from Quartz Ready Cash. No collateral needed, flexible payment terms, and fast approval. All you need is your ID, proof of address, job letter, payslip, and 2 references. Visit your nearest Quartz Ready Cash location today or apply online at Quartz.com. Why wait? Get it done today at Quartz Ready Cash. We are ready when you are.
Conditions apply.
Sunshine Promotions is rolling out the red carpet for all mothers. It's a night of love. Saturday, May 11th at the dazzling Radisson Crown Ballroom. The celebration kicks off at 8 p.m. with the show starting at 9 p.m. Promising a night filled with joy, music, and appreciation. Prepare to be swept off your feet with performances from the legendary Mikey Spice.
I'm born again.
Mikey Spice.
I am myself.
the dynamic Lion Paw, the sensational Valine, and the soulful Laura Lisa. It's a lineup that promises an unforgettable night. Get your limited early bird tickets for just $100 EC and ensure you're part of this grand salute to mothers. Tickets available at Giddens Pharmacy in St. George's, Wall Street, Wharf and Grenville, Chucky's Bar, Cass Unisex Boutique, Quick Stop, Pierce Barbershop in Victoria, Calico Shopping Center in Satez, Rena Mills in Carrickoo, Crown Collection, Health Plus Pharmacy Grenville, Heather's Boutique, and GoToFed.com. Stay connected with Sunshine Promotions on Facebook and Instagram for all details. It's a night of love, Saturday, May 11th at the Radisson Crown Ballroom. Mark your calendars, football fanatics. The GFA is turning 100 this year, and we're ready to celebrate. It's GFA's Legends Weekend, a three-day extravaganza. Kicking off on Friday, May 3rd, and running all the way till Sunday, May 5th. Witness history in the making. The Caribbean taking on the world in a clash of legendary international footballers on Sunday, May 5th at the electrifying Kirani James Athletic Stadium. Get ready to roar with the crowd as iconic legends like Emmanuel Adebayo, El Hadj Diouf, Alex Song, Michael Essien, Luis El Matador Hernandez, Shaka Hislop, Asamoah Gyan, Ricardo B.B. Gardner, Russell Latapy, Shallery Joseph, Jason Roberts, Dexter Dapps, and a whole host of superstars light up the pitch. From breathtaking goals to unforgettable memories, GFA's Legends Weekend promises an epic celebration of football you won't want to miss. Keep your eyes peeled on GFA's social media for the full squad reveal. GFA's Legends Weekend. Be there.
Third-party outages are outages that are caused by parties external to Grenlick. Kite flying is one of the major causes of third-party outages also.
Kite flying over the years has proven to be an issue that has created many outages on our systems.
This Easter, Grenlick would like you to keep your kite in sight. Use an open area with no overhead power lines. Avoid personal injury through electric shock. Avoid damaging property and causing inconvenience through power outages. Enjoy tradition safely. Avoid damage and injury.
Grenlick, energizing our Grenada.
Four Grenadian players selected for the Windward's under-19 team. That story and more coming up in sports.
The MTV Evening Sports is brought to you in association with Quartz, bringing value home.
Keeping up with the kids' growth spurts might mean it's time for a bigger fridge. Don't worry, at Quartz, we got you. Or maybe you're ready to turn your home entertainment up a notch? That means a larger TV and soundbar? We got you. Excited about making your new home feel more like you? We've got you. Need a better mattress for more restful sleep? We've got the size and comfort that's right for you. So shop today and pay later. Whatever you need, we've got you. Quartz, bringing value home.
Now here is Kishon Thomas with this evening's sporting highlights.
With the sporting news, I'm Kishon Thomas. A closing prize-giving ceremony was held for the just-concluded Winlot Inc. Windward's Under-19 Super 50 tournament held in Dominica from April 7th to 14th. Grenada Under-19 emerged champions with last year's champions, St. Lucia, coming in second. At the ceremony, the man of the match and awards for the outstanding performances were given. Most runs went to Theo Edwards from St. Lucia, most wickets Lee John from St. Lucia, most catches by a wicketkeeper went to Javon Adams from St. Vincent and the Grenadines, most catches Jordan Charles from St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and MVP of the tournament went to Kurt Murray from Grenada. The Windward's under-19 boys were named at the ceremony, and four Grenadian cricketers were selected for the team. They are Keatson Murray, Kurt Murray, Giovanni Joseph, and Raquel Sylvester. Among the reserves is Dante Alexander. The cricketers were welcomed on Monday night by Acting President Johnson Richardson and Past President Dwayne Gill of the Grenada Cricket Association.
Welcome you back on
back home, right? And we want to say that we are very, very proud of you guys for what you have been able to achieve out there. I mean, it's shows what hard work. When you put in the work, this is the result, right? So on behalf of the Grenada Cricket Association, I want to say well done, guys, and thank you so much for bringing the title home.
You have a lot of cricket coming up. You have the T10 coming up in June. You have the inter-parish tournaments. And Grenada has to look for a couple new players, right? Opening batsmen. Well, two of you have tasted national level already. You played as a spinner. You went to England, right? So there are opportunities there. So don't feel, boy, the men, 40 men call out now, and I'm not a part of it, and that's the end of it, right? It's now the beginning, right?
The nomination day for candidates to the parish sports councils has been extended from Monday, 15th April 2024 to Wednesday, 17th April 2024. This extension was implemented to accommodate persons who have not yet completed the required nominations form. Elections to the various executive positions take place on Monday, 29th, 2024. The results will be announced live on national television. Stakeholders will be voting for an executive committee, which comes from the members of the parish councils and comprises the following officers: chairman, vice chairman, secretary, treasurer, finance officer, and three directors. Every council shall have its own parish office run by an office manager and parish coordinator. The parish sports council in each parish comprise all registered clubs. Nomination of candidates and elections of the executive council will be electronically conducted. Now for an update on the first set of games played at the opening of the Classic Lighting Caribbean National Netball Tournament 2024. Three games were played over the weekend. In game one, Sprang Queens Rangers B faced Top Strikers. After the first quarter of the game, Top Strikers led 5-1. At the end of the second quarter, the Sprang Queens Park Rangers girls bounced back with a 13-6 lead. At the end of the final quarter, the score was 28-10 in favor of the Sprang Queens Park Rangers. In game two, the same teams faced off in the A division. Sprang Queens Park Rangers won that game 78-16. The third and final game of the night was played between the Sprang Queens Park Rangers male team and Top Strikers. It was a keenly contested match, and at the end of the first quarter, the Top Strikers male team led 10-8. They added further 9 in the second quarter, making the score 19-12. Top Strikers maintained the lead in the third quarter, 28-21, and at the end of the final whistle of the game, the score was 34-29 in favor of the Top Strikers male team, the champion of last year's tournament. And that's the sports. I'm Kishon Thomas.
That's the sports, the weather, and a recap of the headlines when we come back.
The MTV Evening Sports was brought to you in association with Quartz, bringing value home.
MTV Weather Report comes to you in association with Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
Boyo, they gonna fly with kite now. The wind picking up.
I'm coming. Karim, what you doing?
Fly my kite.
Yeah, but not here. You can't fly kite near power lines, boy.
Why not? The wind good.
Because mommy say, kite threads conduct electricity.
Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
Good Tuesday evening, viewers. Back with your nighttime with the forecast and meteorologist, Wayne Williams. The sunny and windy conditions continue through the southern and the central Caribbean islands, while some of the northern islands continue to see showers and some even more gusty winds than we had. We are seeing a slight haze, but further back it is a bit more dense. That could begin affecting us. We should be seeing an increase in the haziness from about Wednesday afternoon to Thursday, and by Friday into the weekend, most likely on Saturday, we're going to see even denser haze affecting the islands of the Eastern Caribbean. The general area remains relatively dry. Any showers at all will be very, very brief, very light, and mostly in the interior, localized areas. We can see the trailing edge of the haze here approaching the islands with some cloudiness, and it's not expected to impact the weather in any significant way if they do bring any showers, because there is some moisture in those areas. If they do bring any showers, again, as I said, they would be very light and brief. The forecast for Tuesday night, mostly fair and windy. We do have about a 30 to 40% chance of some brief localized showers during the early part of the night, but that would give way to the mostly fair conditions after that. The moon rose early on at 12:49, that's just after midday. It's going to set in the early morning at 1:53. Winds remain on the high side between 10 and 22 miles per hour coming in from the east. The minimum temperature tonight, 24. Generally fair conditions again on Wednesday with a slight haze. Easterly winds 12 to 24 miles per hour. Choppy seas, 4 to 6 foot waves. The sun is going to rise at 5:53, set at 6:19. Max work time to 30, feel like 36. UV index still moderate. Generally fair and hazy conditions in both Port of Spain and Bridgetown. They also would see significant deterioration from around Friday. Kingston is expecting mostly sunny skies, partly cloudy in Miami, some afternoon rain for New York, and partly cloudy also in London. From Thursday onwards, generally fair conditions. We could see a bit more clouds around as that haze also begins to affect us in earnest. From Thursday, slight haze, Friday, slight intensifying from Saturday onward. That is it for me for Tuesday night, folks. Have yourself a great night. Join me again on Wednesday.
MTV Weather Report was brought to you in association with Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
Now to end the news, a recap of the headlines. Gov gas station workers to be compensated. Government confirms plans to appoint a new high commissioner to Ottawa. Gov fisherfolk cry victimization. And in sports, four Grenadian players selected for the Windward's under 19 team. On behalf of the news and production departments, I am Troy Gill. Thanks for watching. Good night.
Joseph Cuthbert Rodney Pascal, also known as Joe and Yagadan, of Springs, who resided at Trublu and Montour St. George, passed away on Wednesday, 27th March 2024, at the age of 51. He was the son of Elred Rodney, also known as Zoot, father of Josanne Pascal and Kishona Francois, brother of Natasha, Natalie and Jefferson Pascal, Philip and Alban Gilbert, Dylan Jackson Rodney in Antigua, Peter Duncan in the USA, and Indra Rodney Alexander, nephew of Iris Elcock, Elizabeth Rodney in Dominica, Octavia Rodney in the USA, Delia Rodney in the BVI, Commissioner of Police Artley Rodney in Antigua, Natalie Rodney in St. Martin, and Herbert Morris, uncle of many, brother-in-law of Robert Alexander. Other relatives and friends, including the management and staff of McIntyre Brothers, Michelle Gray, Shauna Francois, Irma Cynthia Francois, the Caliste, Morris, Pascal, Gilbert, Hall, Lewis and Redhead families, Jennifer James, Troy Blackstorm Coutain, June Salhab, and friends and neighbors of Springs and True Blue St. George.
The funeral of the late Joseph Cuthbert Rodney Pascal, also known as Joe and Yagadan of Springs, who resided at True Blue and Montu St. George, will take place on Wednesday, April 17th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill, St. George's, according to Open Bible Rites, and interment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Enid Evangeline Butler, also known as Auntie Enid, of St. Dominic Street, Grove, St. John, passed away on Tuesday, March 5th, 2024, at the age of 99. She was the sister of Alfred and George Butler, aunt of Patsy Cruikshank, Miriam Burnett, Irva Eno, Teresa, Deborah, David, Dennis and Ryan in the UK, Eric, Cyril, Denise, Alfred, Bernadette, Penny and Ruby in the USA, Dudley in Trinidad, Brenda in Dominica, Dave, Cecil, George, Catherine in Grenada, Joanne in Canada, Brent, Gertrude and Percy Glod in Grenada, Alethea Jarvis in the UK, and Cecil Franco in the USA. Grandaunt of many in the UK, the USA, Trinidad and Grenada. Many cousins, other relatives and close friends, including the St. Bernard family of Douglaston, Wilma Cador, the Augustine family and Jeanette Dubois of Concord, Ruth and Sylvia Murray, the Best, Taylor and Steele families of Mount Granby, Paul Benjamin and Margot Wilson of Wharve, many godchildren in Grenada and abroad, the Banfields, Valerie and the Williams families of St. Dominic Street, Norman Noel, Lady Glean and family, the Edwards and Ashton families, Shirley and Lorraine, members of the Gospel Hall Church Grove, the staff and residents of the Hillsview Home for the Elderly, and friends and neighbors of St. Dominic Street, Grove, and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Enid Evangeline Butler, also known as Auntie Enid, of St. Dominic Street, Grove, St. John, will take place on Thursday, April 18th at 2 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grove Anglican Church according to Gospel Hall Rites, and interment will be at the Douglaston Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. James Patrick of St. John St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, passed away on Sunday, 25th February 2024. He was the father of Andy and Wayne, stepfather of Franca, Dion and Jenny, grandfather of Jody, Joseph, Ileana, Ariel, Yolanda, Crystal, Avenel, Sherwin, Shatoya, Shatoya, and Zimri, brother of Andrew, Clotilda, Anne, and Jennifer, uncle of Ryan, Camille, Darren, and Michael, granduncle of Adriel, Aaliyah, and Carrie, father-in-law of Tova and Vernil, many other relatives and close friends, including the Charles family of Mount Craven, the Dubois family of Marley, Tisha and Curlicia Durant in Trinidad, and friends and neighbors in Trinidad and St. John, St. Andrew. The funeral service for the late James Patrick of St. John, St. Andrew, who resided in Trinidad, will take place on Friday, April 19th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Hermitage Evangelical Church, and interment will be at the Tivoli Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
Linus Glenwin Mendez, also known as Glenn Menz, of Lotus Lane, who resided at River Road, St. George, former bass guitarist of Spice Islanders, passed away on Sunday, 7th April, at the age of 75. He was the husband of Teresa Philip Mendez, also known as Teresa Beggs, father of Garth Peters in Canada, Teresa Philip Mendez, Tira Philip Mendez in Dominica, Glenwin Mendez Jr. in the USA, Nikishi Derek, Andy, Kim Alexis, and Nicole Philip, several grandchildren. Brother of Ladish Mendez, Sinclair Lawrence Mendez in the USA, Kendall Depredine, Allison Clowden, Atalie, Homian, Crispin, and Trisha Knight. Brother-in-law of Regan Ned Mendez, Peter Philip, also known as Dixon, and Eli Philip. Several nieces and nephews including Jackie Mendez in the USA, Diane and Paul Mendez, Alicia Knight. Many other relatives and friends including Mabel, Nigel and Nigel and Lockwell, Colin Dow and family, Gora DiCoto and family, Valerie and Richard Lacrette, friends and neighbors of River Road, Lotus Lane, and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Linus Glenwyn Mendez, also known as Glenn Menz, of Lotus Lane, who resided at River Road St. George, will take place on Friday, 19th April at 1 p.m. The funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill St. George's, according to Pentecostal rites, and interment will be at the St. George's Center Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to LaCroix Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on LaCroix Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repair center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call LaCroix Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. LaCroix Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Daniel Nicodemus Frank, also known as Danny, of Bogle's Caracou, who resided at New Hampshire St. George, Grenada, passed away on Saturday, April 6th, at the age of 68. He was the father of Carentia and Shanice Frank, both in the USA, brother of Selena, Michael, and Hendrickson in Caracou, Christina in Grenada, Stephanie, Roy, and Betty in the USA, uncle of many in Grenada, Caracou, and the USA. Other relatives and friends including Carol James, Aunt Natambu ISI of Trinidad, Aunt Lem Clowden and family, Florina Charles, Douglas, Cyrus, Peters, Batiste, and Polymore families of Caracou, and Frank families of New Hampshire, Grenada, friends and neighbors of Bogles and Bialu, Caracou, New Hampshire, and Willis, Grenada, and surrounding areas to numerous to mention. The funeral of the late Daniel Nicodemus Frank, also known as Danny of Bogles, Caracou, who resided at New Hampshire, St. George, Grenada, will take place on Friday, April 19th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at Christ the King Anglican Church, Hillsborough, Caracou, and interment will be at the Mastoma Cemetery, Bogles, Caracou. Funeral arrangements entrusted to LaCroix Brothers Funeral Home. Yolanda Moraine, also known as Yoyi of Latant St. David, passed away on Saturday, 23rd March, at the age of 42. She survived by her mother, Allison Arusha, stepfather, Michael Arusha, spouse, Terry Simon, three brothers, Nigel Moraine, Samuel and Simon Peters, one sister, Sarah Peters Roberts, four uncles, Jude, Douglas, and Fitzroy Moraine and Lexi Peters, two aunts, Anne Moraine and Auntie Joan in Canada, one sister-in-law, Irva Mitchell Moraine, one niece, Naya Moraine, one nephew, Nyron Moraine, many cousins including Elvis and Gloria Moraine and Lee Charles, many other relatives and friends including Wendy and friends in Barbados, Sharika in the USA, Hazel, Carrie and Abigail Moraine in Grenada, the Moraine and Batiste family of St. David, the Mitchell family of Belmont, the Cadeau family of Grant Bacolet, Pastor David King and members of the IPA Church, the Boys by the Shop, friends and neighbors of Latant and the surrounding areas to numerous to mention. The funeral of the late Yolanda Moraine, also known as Yoyi of Latant St. David, will take place on Thursday, 25th April at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Pomeroy Pentecostal Church St. David and interment will be at Latant Family Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Alfred Lawrence, also known as Welcome, of Mount Royal, Caracou, passed away on Tuesday, 2nd April, at the age of 79. The funeral of the late Alfred Lawrence, also known as Welcome, of Mount Royal, Karakou, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. St. Louis Augustine Johnson, also known as Angus and Cap, of Bellevue, St. George, died on Saturday, 6th April, at the age of 67. The funeral of the late St. Louis Augustine Johnson, also known as Angus and Cap of Bellevue, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home.
Louise Agnes Joseph, also known as Lulu of Brazan, St. George, passed away on Thursday, 11th April 2024, at the age of 68. The funeral arrangements for the late Louise Agnes Joseph, also known as Lulu of Brazan, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. James John Abraham, also known as Jim and That's the Boy, of Fontenoy, St. George, passed away on Friday, 23rd February 2024, at the age of 62. The funeral arrangements for the late James John Abraham, also known as Jim and That's the Boy, of Fontenoy, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Alan Bishop of Latonde, St. David, who resided in Maryland, USA, passed away on Saturday, 6th April 2024, at the age of 84. The funeral arrangements for the late Alan Bishop of Latonde, St. David, who resided in Maryland, USA, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Sidney Morris Alexander, also known as Mr. Sidney and Gobeth, of Grand Baccalaureate, St. Andrew, passed away on Saturday, April 6, 2024, at the age of 91. The funeral arrangements for the late Sidney Morris Alexander, also known as Mr. Sidney and Gobeth, of Grand Baccalaureate, St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Reverend Mother Teresa Maureen, also known as Mother T and Aunt T, of Latonde, St. David, passed away on Tuesday, April 9, 2024, at the age of 77. The funeral arrangements for the late Reverend Mother Teresa Maureen, also known as Mother T and Aunt T, of Latonde, St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Leslie Joseph, also known as Candy Berry, Barris, and Lo Bam Bam, of Rose Hill, St. Patrick, passed away on Monday, 8th April 2024, at the age of 58. The funeral arrangements for the late Leslie Joseph, also known as Candy Berry, Barris, and Lo Bam Bam, of Rose Hill, St. Patrick, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Jalil Nathaniel Mason Bell of Frequenty, St. George, died on Tuesday, April 2, 2024, at the age of 18. The funeral arrangements for the late Jalil Nathaniel Mason Bell of Frequenty, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Finbar McQueen of Pedmotar, St. David, died on Friday, April 5, 2024. At the age of 66. The funeral arrangements for the late Finbar McQueen of Pedmotar, St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Bernadine Marine, also known as Buns, of Syracuse, St. David, who resided at Mount Parnassus, St. George, passed away on Saturday, April 6, 2024, at the age of 55. The funeral arrangements for the late Bernadine Marine, also known as Buns, of Syracuse, St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Mary Jocelyn Phillip of Madey, St. Patrick, who resided in the United Kingdom, passed away on Friday, 29th March 2024, at the age of 80. The funeral arrangements for the late Mary Jocelyn Phillip of Madey, St. Patrick, who resided in the United Kingdom, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. Godfrey Millett of Paraclete St. Andrew, who resided at Caliste St. George, passed away on Sunday 31st March 2024 in the USA. The funeral arrangements for the late Godfrey Millett of Paraclete St. Andrew, who resided at Caliste St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Wayne's Funeral Services.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
I'm Pastor Jerry Keynes Douglas, and I'd like to take the opportunity today to express my deepest sympathy to all of you who have lost loved ones, friends, members of your family or inner circle. Probably one of the hardest issues to deal with in life is the loss of a loved one, someone close. There is arguably no harder blow than to be separated from someone as a result of death, and especially so when that death has come as a tragedy, as a tragic circumstance. Our deepest sympathy is with you today. I'd like to share a word of comfort with you from the Word of God that we can all learn from as we deal with bereavement, with mourning, with sorrow, and with the pain of a lost loved one. I'd like to say, from the Word of God, we learn about Abraham, the patriarch. And the Bible says that when Abraham's wife, Sarah, died in Hebron, that Abraham sat down to mourn and to weep for her. And then, after a period of mourning and weeping, the Bible says Abraham arose and he went to do business, to buy land, to build a tomb for Sarah, and to bury her remains. And for all of us, there is that issue of dealing with the grieving period. And yes, it's okay to mourn, it is okay to grieve, it is okay to express that sense of loss and the pain that it comes with it. But I say to you today, you're not alone. Like Abraham, go ahead and mourn. You're not alone. It's natural. Let it happen. However, I also believe that by the grace of God, you're not alone.